Schönen guten Tag, good evening, my name is Marina Westman and we're here at the Gallery Kunstprojekt Format in Berlin-Schöneberg. And today we interview Hector Perez-Sandoval from Mexico and he's currently living in London and he has his show here titled The Source. Hello Hector.
Hi Marina, how are you doing?
Very good, how are you?
Thank you for having me here.
My pleasure. And can you tell us how you came up with the theme, The Source?
Well, it was after me being in Europe for so many months, I went back to Mexico and I thought I needed to get together, you know, the colors, the shapes and the strength of my culture. And so I started looking for inspiration and it was so easy for me to, you know, immediately get into the Maya. And that everything came from that.
This is very nice, you can certainly see this with your paintings. Mm-hmm. Is there a special technique you're using with painting your
work? Well, basically I let myself go free. I quite get the image of my inspiration and I just go free with the brush or the pencil. And I respect all the secondary traces I do, and I remark them as well as an important part of the piece. And then I go in a very mental selection of the colors. Mm-hmm. I always think that the color is the light, so I try to manage the color as light, and I think that's what gives life to my paintings.
And you come from a design background, is that right?
Yeah, I'm originally a graphic designer and I worked many years in design and after that I worked for TV in Miami. I was working in production of many musical shows with Latin American stars.
This is very good. And you can see here on this painting some graphical designs.
Well, I think me being a graphic designer is always part of myself, you know? So, yes, it's a lot of geometrical figure, mm-hmm. and also the color, but the shapes and, you know, these quite motifs are part of the design thing, and also matches with the Maya thing.
Yeah.
Maya is part of, they have their own design world, I think.
Yeah, you can see this in these old historic places where you can go to Chichen Itza or Yucatan.
Yeah,
have you been there yourself?
Yeah, of course. Chichen Itza is a fantastic place. And there's these buildings, they call the front of the buildings, they're like masks. They call them the mascarones in Yucatan. So basically the windows and the entrances are like eyes and mouths, but they're also decorated with these quite of designs. So these paintings has lots of that originally, but I go with lots of my own interpretation of that. I go with a mirror and I try to take the, you know, the shapes of the eyes, of the mouth, and it's just a breaking down. If I get into quite of a trance, you know, making it and applying the colors is very, it's a big challenge.
Yeah, so when you get in that trance, is that for hours or just for minutes? Or?
Well, I go for many hours, you know, I start painting it and I see the painting is getting together and so I can't stop. I go eventually 12 more hours on a row until I get very tired, and then immediately next day I go on top of the painting and I don't leave it until it's finished. Sometimes I am working few paintings at the same time because the painting needs to rest itself and myself too,
right.
You know, but it also gives time to, you know, dry a bit, especially with all these geometric shapes. Sometimes you have to let them dry because you cannot go on the next one.
Yes.
So it's very good. Each painting has its own time, mm-hmm. but it's amazing. I think there's a point when the painting comes to life. That's the breaking point for me.
Right. I have one more question, Hector. Do you use stencils or are you doing everything freehand? Because it looks like, you know, the circles and the shapes look like stencils.
It could be, but not at all. Everything is hand-free, and I'm very picky. I really try to make the circles a real circle.